the kingdom right there because he loved us first. We didn't love God first. He loved us first. I tell you, when I was a sinner going somewhere to happen, I needed somebody to love me. Grandma might have prayed for me, but I'm glad God loved me enough to save me out of wherever I was going. For he so loved me that he gave me Jesus Christ. So that when I found out that I needed a Savior, when I found out that I didn't have it all together, when I thought I was a politician and I was going to, save D.C., God saved me from myself, saying, Sam, look, you're going to have all the answers. I'm loving you, and I'm going to save you from yourself. First of all, I'm going to send you a woman that knows God, who, well, they call her Annette, and I just followed her wherever she went until my heart got right. I'm glad he spared me at a young age. My wife met me when I was a player. I was about 9 or 10 years old, but she said I was a player. That's what she said. Well, like, you're good at 9 or 10. But, and, you know, so we've been together just literally almost our whole lives. Our whole life, we've never been separated. At least, you know, now, because we've known each other all our lives. And God blessed me early. And he blessed me early because he had some place for me to go, and he was saving me from myself. Because he was through the relationship teaching me how to love, because, you know, I had a messed up view of love. I had a messed up view of love. And I'm going to help somebody, because some of y'all still got a messed up view of love. Because some of us love because like this, and, you know, some of us still do, and look, and this don't have no age on it. You can be 80 or you can be 8 years old. Some of us love like this. If I get my way, then I'll love you and do what you say. I got to get my way. If I don't get my way, I'm going to raise hell for you. And I will get rid of you if I don't get my way. You do something to me, I'm going to do something to you. I'm going to hurt you. And some people love like that. You know how perverted that is? That don't even sound right coming out of my mouth. And people are doing it. They're doing it out of church, but they're doing it in church too. Yes. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
All right. And they're doing it in church, doing it today, they did it yesterday, and they will do it tomorrow if they don't get it fixed right now. So, as we learn how to walk in the kingdom of love, you know, Jesus taught us how to love regardless of everything. I mean, Jesus taught us how to love when they came to take him, to put him on the cross, he taught us how to love. I mean, even when somebody was trying to stand up for Jesus, Peter jumped up with the sword, and he was going to do battle, and he was going to kill for his master, his Savior, his Lord, Jesus. And he took that sword, and he swiped off a Roman's ear. And Jesus said, hold up, brother. It ain't about all that. Picked up the ear, put it back on the man, said, I got this. They can't hurt me. They can't take anything that I don't give to them. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give them my life for you. So don't worry about it, Peter. I got it. So as Jesus went with them, he went in the kangaroo court where they lied on him, where they spit on him, where they cut him, where they beat him, where they give everything. By the time they finished with Jesus, he didn't even look like a man. You know, we see all these pretty pictures with them on the crucifix. Believe me, it wasn't that pretty. If somebody sticking nails in your head, thorns in your head that were about 2 inches thick, and beating you with a whip with all these little rocks and stones and pieces of metal on them and tearing your skin off and doing all kinds of manner of things to you, you're not going to look human either. And he did all of that, and they took as a final thing when they put him on the cross, they took his hands and they took those nails in. Instead of strapping them up like everybody else, they pounded him. Pounded the nails in his hand and in his feet. And then hung him up. And he was up there in the ultimate sign of love. Father, forgive them. He didn't say, Jesus, they lied to him. God, they lied to him. They cheated on him. Call your angels down, which he surely could have done. And wipe them out. He didn't say any of that. Father, forgive them, for they are ignorant and don't know what they're doing at this time. They don't know what they're doing. And it says he died on that cross. He gave up his life. Jesus, see, God so loved us that he gave us Jesus. Jesus so loved us that he gave us his life. And as he gave us his life, he saved us. He saved us because he could not raise from the dead unless he was dead. So it says on the first, second, and third day he was, dead. And on that last day, on that third day, it said he rose up. But he didn't raise up for his own benefit. He rose up so that we can have a right to our Father's kingdom. So through Jesus raising up and through his life right now, we have the keys to the kingdom. If we decide that we're going to love one another. See, the short of this message is I can't get to heaven without loving you. Right. You can't get to heaven without loving me. You can't make it like that. You can't make it loving like Flavor Flav. You can't make it like loving like Ray J. Or New York. It's not going to work. It may be good for TV, but everything on TV is not good. I know that took some of y'all back. Okay. But everything on TV isn't good, okay? So, we got to watch what we see, and we got to watch who we mimic and who we follow. We need to love like God intended for us to love, and that's love one another like Jesus loved us in the first place. Because, see, heaven is full of love because that is what God is. See, John in 1 John says that God is love. Love isn't something that God does. Love isn't what God do, that's what he is. And too many of us, for right now, love is something we do. We turn love on and we turn love off the way we want it. But love should be what we are. Yes. See, I have children, and love isn't something I do with them. I just love them because if they do good, if they do bad, if they do what I say, if they don't do what I say, I love them anyway because they're my children. I'm going to feed them. I'm going to clothe them. I'm going to see that they have a roof over their head. I'm going to get them the best education possible because they are my children. I'm just going to love them regardless. They don't have to do anything. If they went wrong, if they were strung out on drugs, if they were on alcohol, if they were in jail, I'm still going to love them because they are mine. And this is how God loves us. In spite of whatever we do, he still loves us. I don't care what you did this past week. I don't care how you sinned. He still loves you. Yes. He still loves you because you're here looking at me right now. Yes. If he didn't, he would have took you out. Amen. So he still loves us regardless of what we do. And see, as Christians and saints, as people that say we know God, we need to love each other regardless. So what they talked about just stopped and they were all twisted. Untwist them and love them anyway. So they talked about your suit, and it was too tight. I know when I was a new pastor, I was still growing, when I was younger. And, my suits got a little tight, and my buttons, got all snug and tight. And some, one of my members said, "Oh, pastor, let me get from in front of you, because if that button pop out, it's going to hit me in the eye." I love them anyway. Hey, man. I love them by my suits. And I wore it again. Until the button popped off. Amen. Okay, I told myself. But anyway, that's what you do. You love them anyway. So what? Somebody's going to talk about you. Sinners talk about you. You still go back to them. They talk about you at the club, and you still go to the club. If they talk about you at work, I guarantee you'll be there early in the morning. Whatever the time the boss say, get there. You won't get there. And guess what? When you go to work, they're going to talk about you again. Why is church the only place somebody talk about you? I ain't going back there. And the people that talk about you, that's not why you're coming in the first place. You're coming because of the Lord. And if the Lord's not talking about you, why not? All the Lord is telling you is you can do it. You can do it. You are an overcomer. You can live the abundant life. You can overcome whatever situation. This is what the Lord's telling you. But yet somebody gonna talk about you. I ain't going back there. If they ain't the Lord, what you giving them what that word away for? Why are you giving that word credence if they're not the Lord? See, that's what happened with these Ray J and AJ shows or whatever. They give their word credence. And you know what? And people would get